So we're out there, and I mean, this is, you can't really imagine this. I mean, it, essentially what I'm going to be saying here is that it's through becoming aware of awareness collectively that we each individually and together are able to see through this lens of a much more highly organizing consciousness. When awareness is aware of itself, you know, as a group, in a group like that, what we see is different. We see everything much more organized. We see everything as the play of consciousness. And so these thousand people out there, these outdoor markets, they're all like doing all these different things, you know, picking up objects and putting it on their heads and sticking it through their nose and everything. And from the perspective of being awake to this singular awareness, everything that everybody was doing felt as though it was, of course, just a single consciousness with manifesting in ways that were unique every moment. And looking into people's eyes, you could notice all the, you know, thousands of eyes out there. It looked as though everybody was conscious of what they were doing. That was what was so amazing, is that you could actually see them being aware of what they were noticing. And so you could see them noticing it and see, feel their consciousness noticing whatever it was that they were doing, which everybody is, you know, actually noticing what they're doing, even if they're not noticing the quality and presence that they're noticing, they are noticing, and you can notice them noticing, and you become aware of the quality of their consciousness as the same as your own, and the same as everybody else's, and there's this vast, you know, grouping of people all acting out of a single consciousness. It's an extraordinary experience. And so everybody in our group was experiencing this, and we were going into shops, like a butcher shop where they're like cutting up fish or something, or meat, and we'd look at it and go like, oh, and there'd be no reaction on our part. Normally we'd go into something like that and go like, ooh, poor creatures that have been chopped up into pieces. You know, and so we would deliberately confront ourselves with weird things that would normally, you know, trigger us in a certain way or make us feel certain things. And we were just like, kind of like Carlo, you know, how calm he is, just like completely unaffected. Amazing. And so the whole bunch of us were like that. And everybody else seemed like they were like that too when we were like that. It was like everybody was like that. It was the most amazing thing. So I've had many such experiences like that. And so it's really, it's not something we can decide, to answer your question. It isn't something we can decide mentally, like I'm going to come from this place. It's rather that, like if we sit on a bicycle, we have to feel our balance to stay balanced on the bicycle. So you can't just think it, you have to feel it. And so in this case, by being aware of awareness collectively, we could be in balance as awareness with all the awareness around us in these thousand people. So it's, you know, making awareness undivided from itself requires awareness to be keenly and effortlessly undivided from its own presence by attending to it, right? And there's really no way around that. I don't see, ever found there any other way around that. So, you know, we can point at it and say, there it is. And then we look where we're pointing and we feel connected to our awareness. So words can appear to help us, but really all they're doing is connecting, getting us to pay attention to attention itself. And a word can point attention at attention, but then attention may only notice itself momentarily. It's when we become dedicated to being aware of this awakeness and notice whether how consistent and unbroken it is in its awareness of awareness. That's when the real weaving and integrity and deepening of where awareness is plugged into and through itself begins to really deepen and get more rooted. So it becomes very, it's self-sustaining, and then it reinforces, like I'm right now, I'm not gazing into the webcam, I'm gazing into my own, the pupils of my own eyes here. And I can shift over to almost look into both eyes at once without going back and forth from one eye to the next. So both eyes are able to look at both eyes, and that makes everything less divided. Then my eyes can be still, and I can take in everything without moving my eyes. And once I can take in everything as an undivided whole, in a fully, and feel my whole body, heart, and mind fully and completely this way, without moving my eyes, then my physical eyes, my visual perception is not inconsistent. It's not jumping around. It's not looking at this and looking at that, looking at another thing in a sequence, in a compartmentalized or like slideshow kind of way of orchestrating my mind experience. But it's my attention is continuously awake to itself. That I'm making as a priority. And as that happens, I can feel my whole neurophysiological psychology becoming woven effortlessly into a single indivisible whole, and that seems to incorporate everything that I'm sensing and feeling and thinking and intuiting more and more so progressively to be experienced indivisibly. And my thoughts become quieter automatically. I don't have to ask them to do that. And I feel this unity spreading throughout my whole nervous system, kind of almost taking it over gratefully. I mean, it feels good. And you all listening to me talk like this, because I can also now, as I enter into this integrity of awareness of awareness in a fully embodied way, I'm better able to sense the presence of your all's attention as indivisible from my own, and then that strengthens what I'm aware of as awareness, and everything begins to feel like it is originating from awareness. And when I get to this level, then it becomes very ever more easy to be aware of everything as of awareness, because everything looks and sense seems to be originating from this one and indivisible activity. Okay, so I would love it if you all would talk about what. Do you have some kind of equivalent way of exploring or experiencing this individually? Like, how do you enter into it while you're talking to people?